another sunny day in downtown Atlanta, Georgia. This looks like a normal light engine move, and it is, except one of these units doesn't actually have an engine. Norfolk Southern number 649 is what's called a slug, and even though it may seem like a bit of an oddity, it's become commonplace around the U.S. So, what is a slug? Well, let's take a close look at this unit that stopped in South Atlanta. This is what Norfolk Southern calls an RPM4C, and it's great for jobs requiring maximum tractive effort at low speeds. One of the first things you might notice is how quiet this thing is. Well, of course it is. It has no engine. Instead, it only has traction motors. Those electric motors are powered by the locomotive it's mated with. In this case, 4721, a GP33 ECO, or ECO. This locomotive is known as a mother unit, and was rebuilt from an older engine by Norfolk Southern. Units like these are designed to be more environmentally friendly, but they're still diesel electric locomotives, meaning they have diesel prime movers powering electric traction motors at each axle. In this configuration, they're not just powering their own motors, but also the motors of the slug. Diesel electric locomotives can't effectively use all their power at low speeds. In fact, their wheels could slip if too much power is applied while pulling a heavy load. But applying this power to extra traction motors helps them achieve greater tractive effort. Here are all the connections needed to make this work. You'll also note that this slug has a fuel tank. It was rebuilt from a former locomotive. In this overhead shot, you can also see all the ventilation fans and diesel exhaust the unit is missing. But what you don't see is the ballast that's been added to give 653 more weight since it does not have a prime mover. This also helps increase traction. Now, this unit has a distinctive feature that not all slugs have, dynamic brakes. You can see some of the cooling equipment at the top center of it. This means the engineer can basically turn the traction motors into generators to help slow down the train. 653 is what's known as a road slug, and it can often be seen switching local industries. Of course, there are also slugs that you'll pretty much only see in yards. NS number 892, working Brosnan Yard in Macon, Georgia, is a good example of this. It was rebuilt from EMD SD40-2 parts and is mated with an SD33 ECO. The large hump in the middle houses dynamic braking equipment. So, now that we've seen some slugs in action, there's still one more question to answer. How'd they get that name? Well, from the research I've done, it's pretty simple, because they perform well doing work at low speeds. So, there you go, another interesting piece of engineering that helps the railroad get the job done.